Hello, and thanks for checking out the video. It's just a quick video of another overnighter, continuing to try and use natural fibres wherever possible, and seeing how it goes, especially with regards to the real testing things when you're using natural fibres, like weight and warmth, as I've mentioned before, and all the drawbacks, and seeing how they can be coped with and hopefully overcome.
One, two, three layers of wool blanket on top of me. It's a small cotton pillow stuffed with cotton clothing. And underneath is actually sheepskin. And I'm gonna double up tonight with another wool blanket as an under mat. To add to the sheepskin, just trying to max out the warmth because I do suffer with the cold. The sheepskin is pretty good at insulation and very good at smoothing out the lumps and bumps of the forest floor. But I just thought I'd try a doubled over wool blanket on top of it, just for extra warmth, a little bit more comfort maybe. See how it goes. cook some rice, but at the same time rehydrated some vegetables I did at home, just dehydrated them at home. So while I was cooking the rice, I rehydrated the mushrooms, peas, and some bought soya chunks. So I'm gonna have to tip those out now. I've got some vegetables here, some fresh vegetables, just to fry down. Well, when I say fresh vegetables, onion, carrot, pepper, and there should be some garlic there as well. Sweet pepper can go in chunky. Because this is going to be a Chinese thing. A sort of a Chinese. So I'm going to fry those off with some coconut oil. And I've got some soy sauce. I've got a bit of seasonal so we get that on the heat. Try and eat before it's too dark. Cheers. Just put some spicy stuff in there, if I can find it. Always the last one. Yeah. Bit of spices. And in a minute I'll add the rice with all the rehydrated vegetables, some soy sauce, give it a stir and get the rice all nice and hot again. And I know it's against health and safety practices probably, but I'm not exactly reheating it, but and then it's ready to go. And here we go then, the Chinese thingy, hang on. Yeah, the Chinese thingy looks nice and actually tastes quite nice, so I better get on with it. As you can hear, it's raining and I just can't get over how dark it is. It's nearly 7:30 and still really dark. I tried to pack up as much as I can. It's very difficult in the dark and the wet. Not a bad night. Ground sheet slipped out under the Pashpalakta slightly and caught a bit of rain, and so the very end of the blanket's got slightly damp, but only a small amount, sprinkling really. So yeah, not too bad.
Well, I'm just waiting for it to brighten up a little bit, and then I can pack up the final things and hike out. It just seems incredibly dark this morning. It's gone 7:30 now, and yeah, it must be very overcast. The rain's not too heavy, so shouldn't be too bad, hopefully. A little bit of light has returned to the forest. I hope you can see. I hope you can see what's going on. It's still really dark.